everybody, welcome back. Today I'll be kind of showing you, or telling you, how what I'm going to be doing next for my help with my chicken breeding and all that. Because at the moment, the hen that went broody only has 4 chicks, and that is, like, I might only get 2 girls out of that. So I'm not really going to be able to make much money off hens going broody and that. So I actually came up with another really good idea that you can get lots of money off, and I'm just going to show you now. Okay, so what I'm going to be doing is I'm going to get, first time around, I'm only going to get 60 fertilized eggs, and for Christmas I'm going to get an incubator. 60 eggs will be able to fit in the incubator. And so what I'll do is I'll have the incubator in the shed with the 60 eggs in it, and I'll probably only get 30 girls, because there's usually half boys, half girls. And what I'll have to do, which I didn't really want to do, but I didn't really have an option with the boys, I'll have to kill them off when they're only young. Usually I like to let them live a bit, a couple of months, so they can kind of actually see the world. But I think what I'm going to have to do is kill them off when they're only young, because we can't really be butchering 30 or so roosters for meat, even though I don't think the chickens that I'll be getting are really made for meat. I think we're just going to have to kill the roosters off when they're only chicks, which I really don't want to have to do, but I don't really have a choice with that. I'll get the chicks, they'll be in an incubator.
So I'll get the eggs, not the chicks, and then I'll have a little table here and a cord running there to the table for the power. And then once they start hatching, they'll get moved into Maggie's old dog crate. I'm putting this mesh on the bottom so they can't go through the gap. So they'll go into there for a couple of weeks, then they'll go into the pens outside. And so just say I have 30 girls,
and at 16 weeks old, I will sell them off, all the girls. If anybody wants roosters, they can have one. So I'll sell off all the girls. I have a lot of people who want chickens. Like, there's so many people who are asking me and my parents if I've got any. So I know there's lots of people who will want to buy, so I'm pretty sure 30 will be enough, and I'll be able to sell all of them, and have enough. I'll sell them for $20 each at 16 weeks old, or however, around that age. And then I think I wrote down, I kind of estimated how much I'll get. And I think I'll go inside and go grab my book, and I'll kind of show you, what I've kind of written down. Alright, so I've got my book here. And that's what I pretty much just write down, just notes about how I can improve my little chicken business, and just that sort of stuff. So I'll just go into the shed because it's a bit chilly out here, and I'm just in a t-shirt and my new overalls that I got. Alright, I'm just going to go here. Alright, so my dad actually came up with a really good idea. Once I've kind of got the first lot, and they don't even have to be outside, they can still be in the cage over there, and I can get the next batch of chicks and put them in the incubator. But what I want to do the second time round, since I'll get a little bit more money off that, but I did have to buy a few things for it, I'm actually going to buy another incubator so I can have 120 chicks. But I think next time around I'm going to get 100 eggs,
So I'll have 50-50, 50 girls, 50 boys. And then, but I will need a larger cage for the brooder for the chicks to go in, because 100 is a lot. And it will be cut down to 50 once I get rid of the boys, but still, that's a lot to just go in that small dog crate. Well, for a dog crate, it's pretty large, but anyway. So, the second time around, if I got at the back of the book here, if I get 100, and then I'll have to pay 175 for all those eggs. And at the end of it, I will roughly get around $1,400, roughly. May not be accurate, but it will be around $1,400 or something like that. And then I can just keep on, then I can just get more. And I don't want just the same breed. I wouldn't mind to get different breeds, like all sorts of breeds. So I think for the first batch I might get like a dozen a dozen of one breed, another dozen of the other breed, until I reach 60 eggs. But yeah, so that's what I want to do, because I know a lot of people like different varieties of chickens, and they do like, I notice like a lot of people kind of like the like cool looking chickens, ones with speckles and spots, and ones that kind of look different or like are really pretty or anything like that. So I think that's what I'll do, I'll just get different breeds. So hopefully, I'm still looking for a good place I can get eggs off and reliably get lots of, because I know there's a lot of people who have fertilized eggs but they don't have like 60 to 100, they only have like a couple dozen. So I do need to find a big factory kind of place, that or a big operation that has lots of varieties of breeds and plenty of eggs that I can take. And I don't really want to get ones in America or overseas. I want to find a place in Australia, so they don't have to like go from another country to another country, just because if they're on a plane, they will rattle around, and even if the box does say fragile on them, they still won't, I still won't get as many chicks, as many chicks hatching as I would like if, yeah, so hopefully that's the one problem with eggs that are fertilized, and you get overseas, or like that you just get them sent to you, they usually rattle around a little bit and they're not usually going to be like, you're not gonna get 100% out of them. And that's the same with any chicken or hen on eggs, but these ones, since they've kind of been moved around a bit, they will be less likely to have more chicks. But that's fine, that's why I want to get a big amount. So what I'm hoping, the first time I'm hoping they will fit in there, hopefully, but once I get rid of the boys, they'll definitely fit in there. So I think I can usually tell from when they're a couple days out old, about a week old, I can tell if they're girls or boys. There are some people who can tell if they're girls and boys from day one. I'm not quite there, but anyway, so this probably won't, this obviously won't fit 100 chicks, so I will have to make a larger area. I'm not sure where I'll put it in here, but most of this stuff will be all cleaned up. So I will make it, it's probably going to be double the size of this, so it'll just be like that. It won't really need to be that tall, but I can get some scrap wood, or I can maybe even buy some cheap something off, I don't know, Facebook or something. So yeah, so hopefully that's what I'll be doing for the next however long. So thank you for watching, hope you enjoyed, see you all next time.